हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर ज्योति गंगूडे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ जूलॉजी, टीटीएचएम कॉलेज नासिक। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन द न्यू टॉपिक नॉन इंसेक्ट पेस्ट। दो दीज आर द पेस्ट बट दे आर नॉन इंसेक्ट पेस्ट नाउ, बट दे कॉजिंग डैमेज टू द एग्रीकल्चरल क्रॉप्स एंड एक्टिंग एज अ एग्रीकल्चरल पेस्ट। ओके, द non-insect pests such as ticks, rats, crabs, snails and squirrels. Okay, now we can see all the pests one by one. Now here, just first we briefly introduced about the non-insect pest. Now here, along with the insect pest, many invertebrates, invertebrate animals, they attack and cause damage to the agricultural crops, against our grains, vegetables, fruits, stored products and livestock. Now, in India, near about 5-10% damage to agricultural crops and stored products are caused by non-insect pests. Now, economically important non-insect pests are tick, then rat, crab, snails, squirrels, birds, jackals, pigs and other wild animals. Now, we focused on the pest tick as well as rat. So we can see one by one. Now the tick, its scientific name is Rhipicephalus microplus, or it is also called as a Poophilus microplus. Okay. Now its systematic position, which belongs to phylum Arthropoda. Here the characteristic feature of Arthropoda is that arthros is which is mean by the joints and podus means the legs. So here the legs are the appendages, they are jointed, and now here the body which is covered by a hard covering, or what we say is that the exoskeleton. Now here in these arthropods, the exoskeleton which is made up of a chitin material, now which belongs to class Arachnida. Okay, so Arachnida, it is a non-insect, okay, non-insect class. So Arachnida, it is a class which includes the spiders, okay, and other insects, okay. Now, other non-insects. Now, Arachnida class, where the body of such a pest, which is divisible into head, thorax and abdomen, where again the body, where the thorax, which shows the presence of either 3 or 4 pairs of legs. Okay. So, totally what we say is that either 6 legs are there or either 8 legs are there. Okay. Now, order Ixodida. Ixodida, we showing here the 4 wings, they are highly sclerotized and hard and they get modified to form elytra. Now, which belongs to family Ixodidae. So, the Ixodidae, which is the common family of the granivorous bean weevil or either in case of seed beetles. Now, the genus Rhipicephalus or either Buophilus and the species Microplus. Now, come to the distribution. So, this pest occurs in the tropical and subtropical regions where such a Rhipicephalus Microplus, which is a very common species which is found in India. Now, if we can discuss regarding its identification marks. Now, here the adults, the body of adult which is oval in shape, and here two conditions are there in case of such a pest, that is unfeeding stage or unengorged condition or engorged condition. So while they are feeding on blood, the condition is engorged, and unengorged means a non-feeding stage or the starvation phase. Okay, so the unfed adults are rather small, about 3-5 mm, but the engorged adult females can reach up to 1.2 cm in length. Now, there is no external segmentation, and here the body of such a pest which is divisible into the anterior part and posterior part. So, here the prosoma or opisthosoma. Prosoma, which constitute the cephalothorax. Now, cephalothorax, so the cephalic region means the head region which get fused with the thorax, or it is nothing but the cephalothorax. Whereas the second part, which is the opisthosoma. Opisthosoma, और इट इज व्हाट वी सेज दैट द एब्डोमिनल रीजन. सो द बॉडी ऑफ सच अ पेस्ट विच इज डिविजिबल इनटू टू पार्ट्स, एंटीरियर पार्ट एंड पोस्टीरियर पार्ट, सिफेलोथोरैक्स और अगेन हियर एब्डोमेन और ऑपिस्थोसोमा, प्रोसोमा और ऑपिस्थोसोमा, सिफेलोथोरैक्स और एब्डोमेन. ओके, नाउ द माउथ पार्ट्स, ओके, दी विथ रीकर्व्ड टीथ्स एंड अडॉप्टेड फॉर पियर्सिंग. नाउ देर आर फोर पेयर्स ऑफ जॉइंटेड और सेगमेंटेड लेग्स. ओके, नाउ हियर इन केस ऑफ सच अ टिक्स, फोर पेयर ऑफ लेग्स दे आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द थोरैक्स. नाउ कम टू द लाइफ साइकिल और लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ सच अ रिफिसिफेलस माइक्रोप्लस. नाउ हियर द लाइफ साइकिल मेनली द टिक विच रिमेन्स active throughout a year, so which is a one host tick. Okay, now means what all the stages are spent on one animal. So in the summer, okay, in the summer season, it can survive for as long as 3 to 4 months without feeding, whereas in cooler temperatures such a stage, okay, such a pest which can remain alive near about 6 months without feeding or without taking any blood meal, so which can live near about 6 months in cooler temperature, whereas in summer which can live without feeding near about 3 to 4 months. But if after that the host is not available, so such a insects, such a pest, they get die due to the starvation. Okay, now such a ticks, they get die if the suitable host is not available, or they get die due to the starvation. Okay, now here the life cycle stages include eggs, leaves as well as adults. Okay, so here in case of egg, first we focused on the eggs. Now the female or adult male ticks become sexually matured after feeding and mate on the host body. Now an adult female tick that has fed and mated detaches from the host and deposit a single batch of many eggs in the environment. Now such eggs, they are deposited either the places such as in the crevices, in the debris or under the stones. Okay, so whatever surface is available on that surface, okay, here the female which can deposit number of eggs. Now here a female tick lays near about 2000 eggs and dies after egg laying. Okay, now the incubation period for such a eggs which is near about 2 to 6 weeks. After that, again such a incubation period which is depending on the environmental factor, which is depending on the climatic conditions. Now egg after the incubation, we show the next stage, that is nymphs. Now here the eggs hatch in the environment and the larvae, they crawl up on the grasses or on the plants to find a host. Now they may be also blown by means of wind or by means of air currents. Now newly attached seed ticks, or what we say is that the tiny larvae, okay, they are usually found on the softer skin inside the tight then flanks and forelegs of the body of host. After that they may also be seen on the abdomen and the briskets, or you have to remember, so such a ticks, okay, they are found all over the body surfaces of the host, particularly where the soft regions are there. Okay, now after feeding the larvae shows two molts, okay, we shows two molts to become nymphs, and after that such a nymphs, they become adults. Now each developmental stage, the stages such as larvae, then nymphs and adults, okay, they feed only once. Suppose larvae are there, okay, the larvae, they feed once and two larval molts are there, so two times such a larvae, they take feeding on the blood meal. But The feeding time which is prolonged, which is several days. Okay. But they do not feed again and again. Only once, the one stage which feeding on only one time. And after that, which transform into or which shows the next developing stage. But the feeding time which is more, up to the several days. Now, here, this is what about the names. The names after maturing, they form to the adult. Now, here, the names develops into adult on the same infested host. Now, here, the life cycle is completed in about 3 to 5 days. Okay. Now, the total time which take to formation of adult is near about 3 to 5 days. Now, after that, come to the nature of damage. Now, the nature of damage here. Such a nature of damage which is done by the larvae, again by the nymphs and by adults. Means all the stages they are damaging to the host. So, here the damage which is done by the larvae, by the nymph and adult, and they suck the blood from their host. Now, the ticks usually affect the softer portion of the host animal. Most of them, they are found on the skin, again near the ears, then again the bases of the tail and with their heads, okay, with their heads embedded into the skin. Now, they suck the blood from the body of host, and while the feeding mechanism, they transmit, okay, while the time of sucking the blood, they transmit the causative agents or they transmit the number of pathogens or disease causing agents into the body of host, or particularly the tick which causing the disease, that is a tick fever or Texas fever. Okay, now this is what about the nature of damage. Now, come to the control measures. Now here, the hand picking and destruction of the nymphs and adult tick pest. Okay. Now here, suppose such a ticks, they are present on the body of host. Then what we have to do? We have to hand picking those ticks. Okay. And destruct the nymphs as well as adults. Okay. By dipping into the kerosene or by manually. After that, the infected farms and ranches which should be placed under quarantine for 6 to 9 months to avoid further or future infestation. Okay. So, some period which is left, or what we say is that the quarantine period of near about 6 to 9 months to avoid the future infestation. Now, again the next control measure is the dust powders containing 1% lindane, then 5% malathion, or again 5% carbaryl are the effective control. Means we have to, by which we have to control the developing stages or the adults of ticks. Okay. So, this is what about the first non-insect pest tick. Now, we can come to the next non-insect pest rat. And I think you all are familiar with the rat. So, its scientific name is Rattus rattus. So, the rats and the bandicoots are household and also agricultural pest. I think you know, the rats, they are found everywhere. In the houses also, or in the agricultural fields also, and again in godowns and so many places. Okay, they visit. So, they are found maybe so many places. But what we say is that in household or in agricultural pest. Now, they also damage the stored grains. Then several types of disease, they are known to transmit by rats. So, beside the consuming the considerable quantity of food, they contaminate much more by urine. Okay. So, while the time of feeding, such a rats, okay, they deposit, okay, or they pass the urine, then their feces, again their hairs, again their sebaceous secretion while the time of feeding. So, in that way, they can transmit, they can contaminate the food material. Now, in India, the common species of rats are black rat, or we commonly called as a rattus rattus, then house mouse, that is Mus musculus, then common Indian field mouse, that is Mus musculus, and brown rat of the Norway rat, Rattus norvegicus. Okay, now this is what about the general introduction about that. Now come to again its identification. Before that, we can see the distribution. So such a rat which occurs throughout the world, and this is the pest which is very commonly found in India. Now here some identified species of such a rat or which is acting as a pest. Now here the identified species such as the lesser bandicoot, then mole rat, again what we say is that field rat, or commonly that is Bandicoota bengalensis. Now after that the grass rat here, which is the Millardia meltada. Then the Jabril rat, that is Tatera cruveri and Tatera indica. Then Indian field mouse, that is Mus muduga. And again the last one, that is black rat, that is Rattus rattus rufescens or Rattus meltada. Okay, now these are the commonest species which is found in India, or they are the most common pest. Now if we can discuss about the rat. So the rats are medium sized and long tailed rodents which belongs to class Mammalia. Okay, which belongs to class Mammalia. Here the body length which measures 9 to 11 inches. Here the males are slightly heavier than the females, and they ranging from 450 to 650 gram, and the female which ranging from 350 to 450 grams in their body weight. Now the Rattus rattus is a pest and is distinguished by a tuft of red hairs at the base of its ears. If you can see the rat, okay, you can observe the red hairs, they are present at the base of its ears. Now fur on the back are orange brown, flanked with black and a silvery white ventrum. Okay, now here the lifespan of rat, which is near about 2 to 3 years. Such a rats, they are omnivorous, means they are feeding on all type of food material. Okay, they are omnivorous. So the rats, they are prolific breeders. Okay, now such a rats, they are prolific breeders. So the sexual maturity is attaining at 5 weeks, and the gestation period, which is 20 to 22 days. Okay, means here total, okay, development of such a embryo which takes the time inside the fetus, inside the uterus, which is near about 20 to 22 days. A single female which can produce 5 liters in a year. So here I mention here liters. So what is mean by liters? So each liter usually consists of 9 to 10 young ones. Okay, so such a 5 liters which is produced by a single female every year. Now here therefore if we can calculate the number of such a rat, such a population which is near about 100 to 150. Okay, so this is very big, right? So near about in a year a single female rat which can produces near about 100 to 150 young ones. Okay, now here you can see again the nature of damage. Now these vertebrate rodents cause damage to agricultural crop, plants in the field as well as in the storage area. Now the symptoms of damage through these rodents include chopped young seedlings, irregular cutting of stems, then patches of depressions seen in the field at the early stages. Now the chewed developing buds or ripening grains, then tillers cut in patches, After that ripening stages, they cut the ear heads and store in their burrows. Okay. Now, miss, which can destruct the crop, which can destruct the entire, what we say that the cultivated field. Now, these rats foul the atmosphere and surrounding of human habitation to such extent that it becomes intolerable for man. Okay. I think you are familiar with the rats. So, we can also lose our tolerance. Okay. Now, here, if they are more in number, then here the man which can cannot able to tolerate this much of population or which becomes intolerable. Now here this pest not only consume the considerable quantity of food, but they foul and contaminate much more by their urine, again by their feces, again hairs and their sebaceous secretions. Now again they acting as a vector of for many number of diseases and which transmit a several disease causing agents to man to human. Okay. Now and we are familiar with the disease, the rat which can transmit the transmitting agent of the disease plague to the man, right? And here the causative agent is what? The bacterium. So, particularly the Yersinia pestis. So, here such a rat which is a very dangerous. Okay. Now, again such a rat which seen to damage the food and feed store packing materials and containers, facilitating the destruction and contamination of foodstuffs. Now, here they can destroy the buildings, structures, containers and personal clothing and again bedding also. I think you are familiar with this. Rat which is omnivorous in its feeding nature and which can eat anywhere. Okay, which can eat anywhere. So, which can disturb the building construction also. Again, which can feeding on the, which can again what we say is that damage or destroy the clothings or our bedding also. Okay. Now, this is what about the nature of damage. Now, there is need to control such a pest. Okay. So, we can focus on its control nature. Now, here such a rats, they are traditionally caught by using various types of rodent trap and killing any appropriate method. Or this is the best appropriate method by using rodent trap. Now, after that, cats are the natural enemies of rodents, right? So, what we say is that rural peoples traditionally domesticating the cat to control the population of rodents in rodents which come under the biological control method. Okay. After that, by hunting rodents in a probable hiding place. Okay. So, hunting the rodents. This is again one of the option to control on the rats. Now, here we have to maintain the cleanliness or proper hygiene. This is very important. So, meanwhile such a rats they keep away. Now, here the stored food in plastic or metal containers, then cleaning of backyard and again rodent hiding places, or again regular basis reduce the chances of rodent pest. Means what here? What we have to do? We have to properly store the food material either in houses or either in godowns or either in here what we say that backyard. So we have to keep all these places clean, so to avoid the contamination of such a rat, to avoid the population of such a rats. Now here ensure the use of garbage bins with cover on the top. Now electronically using iron fences carrying electricity, they are placed around the field and the burrows of rats in night to kill the rats. Okay, this is again a common practice. Now use of ultrasonic devices which can be used to kill the rats. Okay. दिस डिवाइसेस प्रोड्यूस अ अल्ट्रासोनिक साउंड inaudible to human but caused severe pain and irritation in the ears of rat which may eventually kill them. So this is the best practice, use of ultrasonic device to kill the rats. Now if we can discuss regarding its chemical control, here the popular rodenticides which can be used as a poison baits and are very effective on rats. Again here such a baits which contains the zinc phosphide, then barium carbonate, white arsenic, again what we say is that warfarin and mushroom, okay, or we have to take such a rodenticide mixed in their baits. So this is very easy to collect them and to kill them. This is very common practice. Okay, now the last one, that is fumigation, last control measure is the fumigation. So it involves treating of rat burrows with fumes of poisonous substances called as again cyanogas. Okay, the gas of or the fumes of cyanogas. Along with that, a dust or sulfur tablets are effective for controlling the pest. Okay, this is the best practice to control the population of such a rats. Okay, so this is what about the two pests, ticks as well as rats. Okay, in next lecture we'll discuss again the two non-insect pests, crab as well as snails and slugs. Okay, thank you so much.